It took 2 years to fool Mother Nature, but Meade State Fish Hatchery's Head Start Bass program had its first success when 150,000 northern strain largemouth preemies caught a plane to Hillsdale Reservoir in mid-April. The baby bass weren't technically premature. They were just born a month or so earlier than the calendar expected. And that was the result of a carefully planned Kansas Wildlife and Parks project to improve bass survival in Kansas lakes. Only Florida had successfully induced early largemouth spawning when Kansas decided to try it in spring 2009. But late construction at Meade Hatchery and unforeseen preferences in finicky bass led to nothing more than a goose egg the first year, despite the best efforts of biologists involved. It turned out there was more to it than regulating water temperature and length of daylight to fool the bass into believing it was time for love. Things like tank shape and substrate color had to be adjusted to the fish's liking. And backing up the artificial indoors winter cycle of the bass was also necessary. But this year, following Plan B, things were ready and the indoors bass spawned well ahead of their normal schedule. Up to 500,000 Head Start fry will have a growth advantage when stocked into Hillsdale Reservoir. The Meade Jumpstart will give these larger bass fingerlings a chance to eat fast-growing gizzard shad that make up the main prey base in most Kansas reservoirs. Normally, the baby shad outgrow young bass and are unavailable as food. This reduces bass survival. The Meade Hatchery bass, tricked into thinking it was early summer, spawned naturally in fish tanks on black mats. Normally, spawning occurs only under the most undisturbed conditions and usually in darkness. This underwater spawning footage at Meade shows behavior that's rarely witnessed. Kansas Wildlife and Parks is excited about the possibilities of this program to increase largemouth bass populations in Kansas waters. Ultimately, that should mean better fishing for Kansas anglers. I'm Mike Blair for Kansas Wildlife and Parks.